Good evening, YouTube. This is Mitch Santona back with a Transformers review of the BotCon 2010 exclusive Clench. This is Generation 2 Redux pack, and this dude is, I think, the best figure of the pack. This is Clench. Now, he is based off a Generation 2 character, which, to be perfectly honest with you, I don't know much at all about. What I do know is that I believe he was from a European comic, like in the early to mid 90s, and I don't know how often he was frequented in that comic because I didn't follow it back then. I was going to prom and doing other things. I was back in high school or just graduating high school, so I kind of was out of the old loop, and I don't know much about this dude. So, for rating him as a character, I'm going to give him an 8. Just because what I do know of him, I think he's pretty cool. And I think he's cool looking. I think he's the best figure of the set. And just really quick, because I got him out, let me just throw him up here with Onslaught. This is Onslaught from the Universe line. You can see they are of the same mold. Obviously different, way different paint apps, molded in different colors. I'll spin them around real fast. Yeah, but both very good, very cool molds. And that's my next category, which is an 8. I give that an 8. I like him, like Onslaught. Got a lot of really cool little details on him, a lot of rivets, a lot of sculpted in stuff, a lot of clear plastic where it needs to be, where it should be clear plastic, like on lights, which you can flip up, but I don't have them flipped up. There's lights in the back. I just think it's neat. The ribs, this is like vented, so you can use it. It's like a shield that you can see through while you're being assaulted, I assume. A lot of good detail. Detail in the treads here. You can see the... It's just, they put a lot into this, and I really do dig it. So, mold is an 8. Paint on this guy is a 9. I dig this. Again, over the top, but I dig it. There's not much more to say that a lot of people haven't said already. Dude's hot pink and like a turquoise with like a glitter in the right inside the plastic. I think that's right in the plastic. I don't know if this is painted or it seems like it was molded with that in there. So, very cool. And he's got, that falls off very easily, but just a lot of different shades of different paint apps. I mean, there's just different shades of greens and yellows and reds and different shades of pinks, blues. You got like gold and copper. Really cool. So I give it a 9. I like it. I like it in both modes. His alt mode, I give a 7 too. I don't think it's the better of the two. It's a decent enough alt mode. It's kind of a cool assault tank, big old bricky looking, nice and heavy on him. I do dig it, but it's a solid 7. Him and Onslaught are a decent 7. You can put these up and down if you choose. Got a little gun under there. Transformation, I'm going to cut it and we'll get back. Okay, so Clench is transformed and I give his transformation an 8. He is quite nice, and it's a very nice and satisfying transformation. Excuse me. Got some really cool designed in stuff. Just, I mean, it's like, it's really cool because there's like some cages here that the wheels fold up into. The cages open up, and it like allows the wheels to house into them, and then they snap back down, and they really didn't have to go through all this detail. Really, it's just the inside of a leg, and I like that they did that. I mean, I guess I'm speaking on the original mold here. This is not unique at all, except that is, which is very nice and very comic booky. If you can see it, if it will focus in. I'm having a lot of camera troubles right now. I just changed my lighting setup, and hopefully that's going to come in a little bit more clear. But a very comic book looking head. It looks very Marvel comic-y. I don't know if Marvel did these original comics. Like I said, I believe they were European, but I don't know. So robot mode, I give a 9 to. I would have given Onslaught a 9 as well. This dude does not disappoint. I like him. He's blocky. He's heavy. He's got a lot of mass to him. He just looks imposing. He looks like he does not take S from anybody, and I really do dig this guy. His articulation, I give an 8 to. He's fairly poseable, although a lot of heavy ratchet joints, he's got swivels where they need to swivel. His arms can do a lot of stuff. You can put his arms up. You can put his fists the right way too, which is fine. He's got a little hole there, but no big deal. Head turns, shoulder swivel. You got some how you want to display them. You have some options with that. I believe you could probably spin this all the way down if you wanted to do that. I don't know why you'd want to, but just playing around with him. It doesn't have any kind of a waist rotation, but I think you can get him in some very dynamic looking poses otherwise. I do like that the shield tabs in a lot firmer in this mode than it does on the when it just sets on top of the tank mode there. Which leads me to QC. I give it a 7.2. It's decent. The legs kind of, these things kind of flop around a little bit. I can't quite get them to peg in and stay in when I'm posing them. This doesn't stay on very well in either the Onslaught or him in his vehicle mode. In this mode, it's good because there's an extra peg in the back, which, take my word for it, I'm not going to zoom, try to get this stupid thing to zoom in, but there's an additional peg in the back that plugs into his arm, so that's cool. It'll stay. You can, move it around to where he needs to use it for his defensive maneuvering. But very cool. The paint apps on this guy are spot on. I got no problems with this, especially on like a redeco. This is very nice. Very, very nice face. They just really took the time to do this sculpt right, and doesn't have light piping, but he's got some brilliant green, fluorescent green eyes that are just popping and cool. So I do dig this. But I give it a 7 in quality control. Overall, I give this figure a 9. I think he's the best of the Generation 2 Redux, whatever the heck it's called, pack. I give him a 9. If you've got some extra coin to kick around and you like the look of these guys and you only have money for one, I say this guy is a guy you want to get. I think he's the best of the bunch, to be perfectly honest. Although Spark or Pyro is pretty solid too. I just think on the whole, I've always liked this mold better. So just my personal preference, I think this dude kind of rules the pack. So this is BotCon 2010 exclusive Clench.